Right, we is live, Saturday shift, and how we will start today is by a little bit of mobilization. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna have the shoulders go up and then go round forward. Go up and go round forward. Nice big shoulder rolls to begin with. We're gonna do that for 5 seconds. And then after the 3, 2, 1, we're gonna go reverse. Big shoulder, reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then we're gonna put the hands on the hips and we're gonna fold right over and then we're gonna go to the side and then try and go round it back. So be careful, Liz, as we go back. Nice, all the way, sweet. And we're gonna go one direction for 3, 2, 1, and then we're gonna go the other direction. Go the other direction for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then we're gonna mobilize the hips by bringing the knee up and then letting the leg come out over to the side. That's it. As if you're reversing, stepping over this big puddle that you're not even moving. There we go. And we're gonna do that for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then we're gonna gently jog on the spot. So feet, toes, bottom of the foot, nicely cushioned, not too fast, nice pace, gradual bounce, rhythm, nice, quality. Now, in 5 seconds, we're gonna go into jumping jacks. Warm that body up. 3, 2, 1, we go jumping jacks. Jumping jacks. And we're gonna do this for 10 seconds. Keep the knees nice and soft. When you land, try and get some rhythm with your arms going up as your legs start to split. 3, 2, 1, we're gonna stand and we're gonna go out to the front. Big wide angled lunges. Gonna go down, we're gonna hold the big wide angled lunge for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna come back, then we're gonna go out with the other leg. Big wide angled lunge. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Wicked. And we're gonna go into squat with a big arm roll. Squat, big arm roll. Nice, nice. Quality work. Well done. We're gonna do this for the next 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we are ready. So, in half a minute, we are gonna get cracking. Hydrate yourselves. Okay, I'm looking for the timer. Right then. We're gonna start with the body first. And how we're gonna start, let me give you a brief explanation. We're going to start with our feet standing slightly wider than shoulder. We're gonna hip hinge down as far as we're gonna go. We're gonna flex the knees so that our fingers touch the floor. Then we're gonna walk our hands out so we go into a plank. And then we're gonna walk to the hands, and then we're gonna come up and reverse the procedure. So we go into the inchworm. We're gonna start with the inchworm. And then after the inchworm, we're gonna get into a panther shoulder tap. That is you on all your fours with your knees slightly elevated, touching your shoulders with the opposite hand to the opposite shoulder. And then after that, we're gonna get the kettlebell and start moving in our own planes of movement that the universe has allowed us to have. So, when you are ready, each one is gonna start in 3, 2, 1, and we go. Hip hinge, and then get all the way down. Walk, plank, tiptoe to your hands. Get yourself up in your own pace, obviously, and then reverse the procedure. Walk your hands back to your feet. Wicked. We're gonna keep on going with this movement. we've got about 30 seconds with the inchworm. Keep it nice and steady. Keep the rhythm nice and steady. Make sure that you are feeling your body. Go through all the movements that is required. Planes of movement, awareness of body, structural body. We've got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then you're going to get on all your fours. You're going to dig your toes in the ground. You're going to elevate your knees on the floor. And then you're going to touch the opposite shoulder with the opposite hand. Shoulder, tap, panther, shoulder, tap. In your own pace. What we're trying to look for here is your stomach to become nice and tight, braced. Everything being held in with that core. Try to minimize the swing of the body and just keep the body engaged, rhythmic, challenged. We've got another 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're going to get the kettlebell. We're going to get the kettlebell and we're going to go through a figure eight. A figure eight. That is us weaving the kettlebell through the legs as we catch the kettlebell with the hand behind the leg. We're going to elevate our upper body, strengthen the core so that we can relieve that stress that could be made possible if you keep your body down in the swapping position. And it minimizes the risk of smashing your knee with the kettlebell. So we've got another 10. Nine. Keep this going nice and tight, rhythmic. Flow for another 3, 2, 1. We're gonna get the kettlebell. We're gonna have it over the, yeah, that's it. And then we're gonna hold it by the horns, hip hinge, squat, squat, and squat. We are gonna be squatting for 15 seconds. After 15 seconds, we are gonna then transfer it to a squat press. So be careful, Sarah, when you are going to be pressing. We've got another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we press. We squat, we press. We squat, we press. Well done, great work. Awesome work, Dan. Great work, Liz. Excellent, Sarah, brilliant. Nice adaptation there. Wicked stuff, awesome. Keep this going for another 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and we're going to put the kettlebell down and go into jumping jacks with a little bit more fiery pace, a little bit more fiery pace. There we go. Get that blood flow. Get that temperature rising. Wicked work. Wicked work. Everything in line, online, working for the good. Well done, keep it going, nice and rhythmic. The arms go up as the legs split. And as the legs come in, the hands go beside you. For another 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. You're going to get something that you can lean on and you are going to hold yourself in a plank. Sofa, chair, bench, stool. Hold it in that plank. We're gonna hold it. We're gonna feel the heart beat. And we are gonna be focused on our heart so that we can be present with our breath, trying to bring that heart rate down. As the heart rate comes down, you're gonna feel a nice tightness in the lower back, in the stomach, and that is you connecting your mind to your muscle. After 10 seconds, we're going to go to a side plank. The side plank will be you releasing one hand off, turning to the side. You can elevate the hand on the other side if you want. 3, 2, 1, side plank, side plank. There we go. Nice. The aim here is to still keep your body nice and tight. Make sure that your hips are not dipping. Nice. Great work. We've got another 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. We're going to turn to the other side. We're going to turn to the other side. And we're going to go into a side plank on the other side. Nice and tight. Keep the body upright. Don't allow the hips to level themselves lower than what they are. Keep the hips in line with your armpit. Nice lining. 5, 4, 3, 2. Go back to the plank. Go back to the plank. And in 5 seconds, we're going to go into mountain climbers. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we go. Mountain climbers. Get your knees pretty high towards your wrists. Get that flow. Get that rhythm. It's all about your flow, your rhythm. However you feel that you are challenging yourself, dig deep and just keep on pumping those knees up to the wrist. Keep it going. Nice and tight. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And well done. Well done. Hydrate yourselves. Great work. Great work. Awesome work, everyone. Well done. Right. Right. Get your breath back. Weights. So, dumbbells, tins of non-perishable foods, anything that has weights. We're going to start with your shoulders, so be aware of it, Liz. And we're going to involve every plane of movement that the body allows us to do. So we're going to go sagittal, we're going to go lateral, and we're going to go transverse. So when you're ready, we're going to start with a side lateral raise. So it's coming out to the side, but it's going at an angle. And what we're trying to aim for is continuous tension, continuous motion. And when we level up our arms, the hands are going to be level with our shoulders. Not too much higher than the shoulder. Nicely controlled, nicely tight. There you go. And after 5 seconds, we're going to bend our upper body over and we're going to go into rear delt raises. Rear shoulder raises. 3, 2, 1. The arms go down. The body engages. The chest goes level to the floor. And you're going to go into rear shoulder raises. Whenever you raise your arms, make sure your thumbs are pointing forward. We do not want your thumbs pointing up because that means that you are going up and back. We do not want up and back. We want up and out. We want to savor the movement. Engage the rear shoulder. With your thumbs up, you are not doing that. You are going to be working a different body part, which we do not want. We've got another. 3, 2, 1. We're going to hold the dumbbells in front of our body. We're going to hip hinge and we're going to allow our body to go right down, as far as it will go down without overarching the upper back. You're going to come up and you're going to find yourself performing a stiff, legged, dead lift. You're going to feel it in your stomach. You're going to feel it in your lower back. You're going to feel it in your hamstrings, your calves, your glutes. Dig your heels in your ground and push the ground away as you elevate your upper body up. When you go up to the top in 5 seconds, you will also add a side, lateral, angle, raise, the one that you started off with. 3, 2, 1, side angle raise. And then we go back into the stiff-legged deadlift. Side angle raise. And as promised, we are taking the body through its natural planes of movement. Transverse. As we come up, we go into lateral, stroke, sagittal, extension, flexion. Well done. Awesome work. Brilliant. Keep this going. Keep this going. You're going to be doing this for another 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, we will remain upright and we will go into bicep curls. 3, 2, 1. Bicep curls only. Bicep curls only. There you go. Good work. Now this bicep curl that we're doing now, we're going to keep it constant. After 5 seconds, what we're going to do is hold the dumbbells up as if we've just finished off a bicep contractile curl. And then we're going to go into a squat. 3, 2, 1. We hold the bicep contracted and we go into a squat. We go into a squat. There we go. We're going to be doing this for the next 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, we will then connect the bicep curl movement with the squat movement. We've got another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We now bicep curl and we squat. We bicep curl and we squat. We've got to be aware that we are not allowing the body to give us too much assistance. So we don't want our midsection to be moving in a manner that it resembles a swing. We want to keep the tightness going. After 5 seconds, we are going to add a press to this movement. 3, 2, 1. Bicep curl, squat, press. Bicep curl, squat, press. Bicep curl, squat, press. Good work, great work. I'm going to throw in a curveball. After 10 seconds, we are going to hold the bicep curl contraction and we are going to go into reverse lunges. After 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bicep curl, reverse lunges. Come up, keep the biceps in that contractile position as we reverse lunge. When we reverse lunge, we are going to reverse in an alternated fashion. So your left leg and then your right leg. Every time that you extend your leg out to the rear, you're going to make sure that you embed your toes in the ground. Elevate your knee from the ground. Do not allow that knee to touch the floor. Your biceps should be getting pretty damn burnt right now. Keep this tightness going. You're doing very, very well. After 3, 2, 1, we're gonna stand up, go into a bicep curl, go into a squat, go into a press for 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, we're gonna go into a front lunge. Go into a front lunge. And we go. 3, 2, 1. Hold the bicep in its place and we go into a front lunge. There we go. Good. Great work. I think I was saying before reverse squat, it was a reverse lunge. I don't know if I was doing that. Anyway, it's obvious that the oxygen is not getting to my brain. So keep it going. You know what I mean, because you are furious experts, legends. Keep it going. We've got another 10 more seconds with this movement. Keep this going. We've got another 5 seconds with this movement. Keep it all nice and tight. 3, 2, 1. We stand. The dumbbells come to our side. We go for a front angled raise. We go for a front raise. We bend ourselves over. We go for a rear shoulder. All of the shoulder. There we go. Good work. We are getting medial delt. We are getting anterior delt. We are getting posterior delt. Front shoulder, medial shoulder, rear shoulder. All of the three heads on the shoulders is what you're getting right now. Great work involving the traps as well, because it will all come up. I lost the sequence. We go into a side lateral angle, front raise, bent over, rear delt. We're going to be doing this for the next 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, we're going to need a bench, we're going to need a sofa, we're going to need a stool, and we're going to go into tricep dips, because the triceps have been made, engaged, warmed up, primed up, ready for the next movement. 2, 1, get your dumbbells down. And then find yourself a position where you can sit with your hands either side of your hips, slide off the seat, and we go into 2 footed dips. Make sure that the sofa, the chair, the stool, the bench that you've got behind you is very close to your back. Keep it nice and tight. There we go. Keep it fundamental, keep it functional, keep it tight. For another 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, raise it all the way up, glute thrust, hold your body in a glute thrusted position at the top. Nice contractile glute thrust, hip thrust. Glute raise, whatever you want to call this. Make sure that you are feeling it in them glutes, hamstrings, shoulders, triceps, stomach, lower back. After 10 seconds, we are going to have a breather. So keep it nice and tight throughout this whole sequence of seconds that will come down and end up with 0. Well done. Well done. Awesome work. Hydrate yourselves, and we have Hassan. Good morning. Right in. Well done. Awesome work. The next phase will be a little bit of a free-for-all. We're going to get on the floor, and we're going to put our feet on, well, you can see the bench there. We're going to put the feet on the chair, on the stool, on the bench, and we're going to go into crunches. Your crunches can be done with your hands behind your ears or laced behind your head. The only thing that I ask is that you don't put pressure on your head so that your chin doesn't go into your chest. So leave a golf ball size gap between your chin and your chest. After that, we're gonna elevate the legs up, and then we're gonna point our fingers to the toes, and we're gonna go into a V crunch. After the V crunch, we're gonna get back on all our fours, and we're gonna go back into the panther shoulder tap. After the panther shoulder tap, we're gonna go into alternate lizard lunges. And I will show you what that is, but you already know what that is. It's like a stretch. So we're gonna have 4 movements back to back, and then there are gonna be more movements that I haven't told you about. The first movement is us on the floor, with your backs on the floor. Feet elevated, on the seat, on the chair, on the stool. So you're going to lace your fingers or have your fingers underneath your ears. And what we're going to do is start to crunch in 3, 2, 1. We crunch. What we have to make sure of here is that our chin is always above the chest. Keep a nice little gap between the chin and the chest so that it doesn't block any airway going in, doesn't block your flow. Always keep your elbows flared throughout the whole movement. Do not allow your elbows to come in. That is a sign that you are needing another body part to allow you to crunch up. We are not sitting up, there is a difference. We are crunching. By crunching means that it's minimal movement. Only the shoulder blades are going to elevate from the ground. Temporarily, fractionally, marginally. Keep it going for another 5. After 5, we're going to lift our legs up. We're going to point our fingers to the toes, and we are going to V crunch. 3, 2, 1. Elevate the legs. and then point the fingers to the toes and crunch. Crunch. Your stomach now should be fully engaged. Keep that neck as relaxed as possible. Just try to engage into the midsection. Be present with that tightness. Feel the open tightness. There you go. It's not exactly open, but it's getting tighter. Keep it going. Keep it going. We've got another 15 seconds of this beast. After 15 seconds, we are going to get onto all our fours, and we are going to go into the panther. Shoulder tap. After 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We now get onto all our fours. We dig the toes in the ground. We elevate our knees. Elevate our knees from the floor. And then opposing fingers to the opposing shoulder. Tap that shoulder. Nice and rhythmic. Nice and tight. Your stomach should be a ball of cement right now. Nice, hard, quick drying cement. Nice tightness. Keep it going. Quality work, everyone. Quality work. Embracing that core. Functionally working. After 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're going to go into lizard lunges. So we get into a plank. We lift one knee right up to the elbow, and then the leg goes down the other way. And then we alternate legs. So we are getting the knee up next to the elbow. Alternate lizard lunges. Your stomach should be on fire. Keep this going. Awesome work. Nice and tight. After 15 seconds, we are going to go into a plank. You can do it in a press-up position, or you can do it with your elbows, forearms resting on the floor. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we go into the plank. You can do this any way that you want. Elbows held, plank. Make sure the lower back is nice and straight, tight, feeling that stomach engaged. After 10 seconds, we're gonna get the kettlebell and go into more functional, core functional movements. 5, 4, 3, 2. We're gonna get the kettlebell. Well done, everyone, well done. Get the kettlebell, and the kettlebell starts by the bottom of your foot so that you're engaging the body, tilting the body, and then as you're on one side, swing, come up, grab the kettlebell with the other hand, swing down, right beside the foot, right beside the leg. Be careful to not smash that shin. You've got to be totally aware. Once you get the confidence in the movement, you will speed up. You will challenge yourself with this rhythmic motion. You will be confident and you will flow. All about the body in flow. And the most important thing, we are shifting the body for the Saturday shift. Well done, everyone. Keep this tension on. Nice and tight. After 5 seconds, we're gonna grab the kettlebell with one hand and we are gonna swing it through the legs. So be careful of the mobility, be careful of your motion. Do not allow the kettlebell to have any kind of authority. You're the one that's gonna have the authority. I said 5 seconds, it's gone 15. We get the kettlebell now through the legs, one hand, through the legs, eye level. Let's go. Swing that kettlebell. Make sure that you are the authoritarian. Make sure that you are dictating, not the kettlebell. It's under your watch. Keep it going. wicked work. Ladies and gents, for another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab the kettlebell with the other arm. Grab the kettlebell with the other hand and swing, swing, swing. Well done. Great work. Awesome work. We're going to do this for another 15 seconds. After 15 seconds, we're going to grab the kettlebell with both hands and we're going to go into a stiff-legged deadlift, followed by an upright row. After 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, we go into stiff-legged deadlift. Make sure your feet are wider than your shoulder so that you have that mobility, that range, that freedom of those hip flexors, engaging the hips, glutes, hams, quads, stomach, lower back, forearms, biceps, shoulders, neck, the whole thing, the whole thing. It would have been quicker for me listing the body parts that this doesn't involve, which are not many, if any. After 5 seconds, we are done and we go into our final round. 3, 2, 1. Well done. Well done. Great work, everyone. Great work. Right, we're going to go into our final round. I don't know how long it's going to be. I don't really know what we're doing. That should fill you with loads of confidence. Right then. Okay. We're going to start. Just to let you know, get your breathing, get your breath back. George, get your breath back. Just to let you know, we're going to start on the bench, on the seat, on the chair, whatever you got. We're going to go into dips. 10 second dips, both feet planted. Then we're going to go 10 seconds, pistol dip. So one leg's going to come out. Then we're going to swap over the leg and we're going to go 10 seconds pistol dip there. Then what we're going to do from there is turn around and go into press ups. Press ups will be 10 seconds. After 10 seconds of press ups, we're going to go 10 second plank. After 10 second plank, we're going to go into another 10 seconds of press ups. And then we're going to go back into planks and we're going to raise the legs up. So we're in 10 seconds with one leg up, 10 seconds with another leg up. Then we're going to come off of that and we're going to go into some sumo squats with the kettlebell. After sumo squats, we're going to go to side lunges with tuck jumps. So, I don't know where that just came from, but we're going to do all of that. Hopefully I can remember what we're going to do. So the first thing that we are doing is dips, okay? 10 seconds with both feet planted, 10 seconds pistol, 10 seconds pistol. Swap around, press ups. Go with me, go with me. Hopefully I can remember what we're about to do. So, final round, ladies and gents. Final round. Slip the butt off the sofa, seat, chair, stool, bench, and we dip. We dip. Both feet. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We go. One leg extended out. Pistol dips. Pistol dips. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Get the other leg out. Get the other leg out. Pistol dips. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We turn around. We go into press ups on the chair, on the stool, on the bench. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, keep that back nice and tight, nice and straight. 4, 3, 2, 1. Holding the plank, both feet on the floor, arms tight, solid, rigid, strong. Another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to the press ups, back to the press ups. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, plank, one leg raised, three-legged plank. Keep the butt down. Keep your toe pointed to the floor. Stretch the calf, stretch the glute. Engage the glute, engage the ham. 3, 2, 1, put your feet back, raise your legs up, and we go. 10, 9, sumo deadlift squat. Actually, it's a sumo deadlift. Let's go. Sumo deadlift, where our feet are extra wide. Going down, keeping that body nice and tight. Shoulder blades pinned back. After 10 seconds, we're gonna flip the kettlebell on its horns, and we're gonna go into sumo squatting. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We get the kettlebell on its horns, and we go into sumo squatting. Make sure your knees are in line with your toes. 10 seconds for this one. After 10 seconds, drop the kettlebell, go into body side lunges, and then we're gonna go tuck jumps. After 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, drop the kettlebell, go into side lunges, come to the middle, tuck jump, side lunges, come to the middle, tuck jump. Let's go. Last 15 seconds of this session. You have done extraordinarily well. You have shifted the body to epic proportions, epic levels. Well done. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 1, 1, 1. Well freaking done, everyone. Excellent work. Excellent work. Round of applause, well done. Well done, Sarah. No time for sleeping, I'm afraid. Right, we have time for stretching. So we're just gonna go into a nice cool down of a stretch. I'm gonna change this music, and then it'll give you a few moments so that you can prepare yourself for getting yourself nice, primed, ready, in a safe space, clear space. I'm gonna put some deep focus music on. Okay. Right then, let's get rid of these adverts and let us begin. So, what I'd like you to do is stand with your feet planted on the floor. Now, what I want you to get from this is a release. Release of that tension that you have now introduced to your body. Not only introduced, but your body is a ball of tension. We're gonna allow that tension to release. And how we do that, first of all, is by focusing on the top of our head, right to the top of our head, with our shoulders down, our arms by our side, and our feet planted. Just focus on the top of your head. And then I want you to scan your body from the top of your head, running it down to the forehead. Go down from the forehead. Feel any tension in that forehead, like above the eyebrows, and relax it. And then I want you to feel the facial muscles around your nose, cheeks, mouth, chin, and I want you to relax it. And then you're going to focus behind and below your ears. And I want you to scan and run down what you could see. So vision, feel that neck now starting to elongate, starting to expand, starting to elasticate. Relax your shoulders. So whatever weight that you had on your shoulders now, let it be gone. Relax it. Automatically, you will feel a blood flow in your fingers. So your fingers, I'd like you to start wiggling your fingers. And that will accentuate, circulate the blood flow. I want you to now to focus on the side of your back. So both sides, lats. And then I want you to feel the V taper from the outside of your lats right down to your stomach. As if you were virtually reaching out to the reflection of yourself and then running your hands from from the outside of your body, from the top to the midsection. So now you're on your hips. From being at your hips now, I'd like you to relax your hips by tilting your pelvic behind. So just a little pelvic tilt. Lean your upper body slightly forward. What you're going to get now is a flow through your thighs, going down to your knees. Your knees may feel slightly heavy now. Release that heaviness and let it go to the feet. So right now you have got all the heaviness in your feet. Your body is now in flow. What we haven't done is concentrate on the breath. So what we're going to do is take 4 seconds, deep breath in through the nose, hold it for 4 seconds, take the breath out, 5 seconds through the mouth, and hold the breath for 4. And then we're going to return back to the body. So when you're ready, we're going to go 4 seconds in through the nose. We go now. Feel that belly rise. Don't allow the shoulders to lift. And then hold the breath for 4 seconds. And then let the air go for 5. Let the air go for 5. And let it all go. Hold the breath for 4. And then be present with the breath. Just breathe as normal. And we're going to hip hinge. Engage the hips. Allow the upper body to leverage itself lower, down, lever. Make sure the back's quite straight. When you get to a point where you cannot go down any further without rounding your upper back, then round your upper back. Round your upper back and then flex at the knees. Where you should be now is on the floor with your hands. If you're not, then that's where we need you. And then we start walking the hands in front of us. We're going to walk the hands so that our body is now in an inverted V, upside down V. And where we are at now is known as the downward facing dog. From the downward facing dog, you are going to collapse your knees right down. So you go into what's called a floating tabletop. So your knees are elevated from the ground, your toes are dug into the ground, and your hands are firmly fixed underneath your shoulders. You're going to relax your knees on the floor and you're going to feel a release of tension. You're going to be admiring the way that your body is dealing with this flow, with this tension, with this release. And you are going to celebrate your body. And one way we're going to celebrate it is by reaching out as far as we can with our hands. We're going to plant our hands on the floor and we are going to push the ground away. As we push the ground away, our hips will go back as if they want to sit on our heels. But they're not going to do that. But they're going to make a damn good job of it. You might be super flexible, unlike me. And you might be right now sitting on your heels. If you are, then accept it. Welcome it. Celebrate it. You are magnificent. Now what we do, we allow the forearms to go flush on the floor. And then we slowly bring our forehead to the floor. And we relax our neck. We relax our shoulders. And right now you should be feeling your lower back opening up, your upper back opening up, and just an all-round sense of release. And now you should be going into what's called stillness. Your body is now in stillness. Be present with your breath. Celebrate the way that your body has gone from a furious, fiery engine to now a calm candlelight. Without any chance of that light being blown out, you are the light that will shine in not only your life, but in someone else's life. Because you have done something magnificent today. You have got up, you have shown up, and you have owned it. So well done. We're going to slowly now lift our upper body up, and we're going to slide our hands so that they get underneath the shoulders again. We're going to dig the toes in the ground, and we're going to elevate the knees again. We're going to go temporarily in the floating tabletop. We're then going to get back into the downward facing dog and we're going to push the ground away so we get a nice deeper lat stretch and open up that lower back. We're going to walk our hands to the feet and we're going to flex at the knees so we become like a little ball. And then we're going to open up that ball by sliding our hands up the top of our feet, sliding our hands up the shin. As our hands go up the shin, our body is going to start to release. And we're going to start to stand up. As we stand up to the top, I want you to take a deep breath in through the nose. And as that breath goes in, I want you to release your hands out. So you're going into an upward motion semicircle with your hands. You're going to raise your hands right at the top and you're going to hold your breath. By holding your breath, you're going to extend your fingers to the sky. You're going to make your spine very tall. And then you're going to release the breath. As you release the breath, your arms are going to come down in a lateral descend, semicircle, so that they now land beside your thighs. You're going to take a moment to celebrate the way that your body has gone into flow. Take this moment to think about one word that your day will be consisting of. My word is flow, because it always is. Thanking you.